Hi, I'm Jean Fiorini. Thanks for joining us for the fourth Tarot Tip of the Week. We're going to talk about something today that is intrinsic to the tarot system but is sometimes overlooked. And that is that we're working with a system of symbols. We're working with a system of pictures, images, colors, diagrams, landscapes, and people. And sometimes we get caught up in the book information and or the intuitive information, which is not to be overlooked, but we can get caught up in that and forget that we're looking at pictures. The tarot tip of this week, the fourth tarot tip, is pay attention to the literal visual cues that are on the cards. Now we're going to take a look at a couple of examples. So in this first example, we've got the Queen of Cups and the Queen of Swords. When these two cards come up in this kind of a position, we get the idea that there are two forces that are opposing each other, that these two queens are not communicating, that the Queen of Cups, which is what is closest to our hearts, and the Queen of Swords, which might represent what our mind tells us or the principles of the thing, that these two things are not communicating, whether they are between two different people or whether this is an inner dynamic. This shows a polarized situation between two different personalities. If we were to switch the position and look at them as if they came up on the table like that, facing each other, here we get a wholly different story. Here we get, okay, these two still have differing energies. The Queen of Swords is very idealistic, single-minded, independent, and the Queen of Cups is still very driven by what her heart wants and what her emotional needs are. And yet, with them facing each other, we get a sense that there's a harmony here, that the heart and the head might be working toward the same goal. So here, the visual cue about who was looking at whom or who was not looking at whom can really give us a lot of information about what's going on.